Welcome, this is the energy vibration reading for all the Sagittarius Sun, Moon and Rising for the second week in July. I want to say thank you for being here. Thank you for the huge support that you Sagittarians has been doing for me. Welcome, if this is your first time, please subscribe and stay with our channel. Please support our channel. Please thumbs up, like and share, and listen to your Sun, Moon and Rising sign. Go back and listen to the July reading because this is important. There's a lot of message. On top, I can say that this is an air week with the zodiac energy of water, so it's going to be a lot of cleansing. And I've been seeing this format coming up the whole week for a lot of signs, the King of Cups and the King of Swords. So a lot of you people are going to have to deal with situation, whatever situation that was blocking you with the King of Cups, or you were blocking him, it's going to come to an end on Tuesday. For the King of Swords, some of you are going to walk away from a relationship that you're having with a Gemini, a Libra, or a Gemini Libra, or a Aquarian. So whatever is happening for you Sagittarians, you're going to walk away. It can be a woman or it can be a man, but on Wednesday you're going to decide that you're removing yourself from this situation. The number eight is going to be a very vocal point. Number one and number eight, 88 is going to be a very positive vocal point for you, and this is going to be extremely good. Whoever was trying to get away with something, they're not going to get away with it. There is going to be your focus, the Six of Wands. The Six of Wands is a victory and success and good news coming out. Victory and success and good news coming out. And this could be for your promotions, a lot of promotions. This could be, yeah, a lot of promotions. And with that promotions, the number 88 is right beside each other. So there is going to be money also with this promotion. There is going to be money whatsoever that was happening. Let me look on Tuesday is going to be one of your best days. Tuesday is your best days because whatsoever that has been happening, the energy vibration is going to change on Tuesday. So you have 1, 8 and 88 as your number. As we look at this energy vibration, we have the Ace of Cups. The Ace of Cups, new love is coming in for a lot of people, and this is real love. New love is coming in for a lot of people. You have new love for some people, and you have new opportunities for some people that are going to come in, and it's going to be very positive. As we move forward, we have the energy vibration of the Tower, and the Tower energy is the energy of an end to a situation. It could be the end of a relationship with someone who is an air, who is an Pisces, a Cancer, or a Scorpion. It could be the end of a relationship, or whatever that this person and you had is going to come to an end. There is going to be a huge cleansing. As we look at the middle of the week and the crowning of your week, you have the number 8 of Cups. This is coming up for a lot of fire sign. You're moving away from something. You're ending a relationship with someone of an air sign, which is an Aquarius, a Gemini, or a Libran. Okay, so whatever is happening, you're moving away from this King of Swords. Whoever this King of Swords is, you have decided to move away from them. On Thursday, you have the Eight of Pentacles, which is another eight. So the eights are dominant in your reading as usual. Even if the money energy don't come up, the infinity energy comes up, and there's going to be a lot of new beginnings. A lot of money is going to roll for you guys. So this is what the energies are saying in this week, that you know the Eight of Pentacles is here, but yet still money is about to come into you, and it's going to be money or little gifts of things. It can, money comes in all different forms. It comes in people helping you, little gifts, people are you know, reaching out to you, and that sort of a thing. I'm sorry, it's hot. So okay, as we look at Friday, you have energy vibration with the King of Swords. So whoever this King of Swords is, he's your enemy. So think about it very good. Think about who is that person, because he is not carrying a high energy vibration for you. There is something that this person is keeping behind. So think about who this person is. It could be an ex-boss. It could be someone who you have partnered up with in business. Think about who this King of Swords is, because he is a dishonest person and he is not carrying energy. He was trying to get away with something, and on Saturday you're going to realize that it didn't work. So see, everyone is falling off falling off the stairs. And I love these cards because they give just the exact meaning of what is happening. So whosoever this King of Swords was and was trying to get away with something, he's going to fall on his back, okay? And you're going to overpower this person, because he's going to really fall on his back. The Queen of Pentacles is here on Sunday, and there is going to be a wonderful celebration with the Queen of Pentacles. So this is nice. I know the card is not one of the most delightful one with the Queen of Pentacles, but she is here and she has come to help you celebrate, and this is going to be wonderful. So whoever this person is, she could be connected with this King of Swords, but yet still she is having a celebration, and he is going to be your enemy or someone who's working against you. But whatever is happening, know that love, new love is coming in, and new love can come in different forms. It's going to affect people in different forms. It's going to affect people with new relationship. Good news, good information is coming up. It's going to affect other people in situations, so as if new work, new connection with groups, but new love and new work is coming in this week. Whatever the situation that you had with a Cups person and a Pisces or a Scorpion, I'm getting the Cancers too, it's going to be cleared up. And whoever tried to do something against you, in the sense the Tower energy is there that is breaking that down, and new things are going to come in. Whosoever was trying to get away with something, it's not going to happen, okay? And as we look in the foremost full corner of your reading, what is happening is that you're moving away from a situation. Some people, some women who had relationship with an Aquarius, a Gemini, or a Libran, you're leaving that situation behind and you're moving forward with your life in some aspect. As we look at the second half of the reading week, we have the energy of the Eight of Pentacles. But the Eight of Pentacles is as if you're working hard on something, or you're working hard at work. This is going to bring you in a promotion. This is going to bring you in little gifts and support. And whoever this this Queen of Pentacles is going to celebrate with you, whatsoever is happening. This Queen of Pentacles, you don't have to know that she's going to celebrate with you, but you know, it can be a celebration that she's saying, you know, well done, well done, you have done so well, well done. And but you know, be aware of a King of Swords, which is an Aquarius, a Libra, or a Sagittarius. Be aware of this person, because this person could be coming at you without you even knowing what is happening. And this is can be an ex-boss, an ex-lover, or ex-boss. This is, and it can be a king, but it can be also a queen. So be aware of whatsoever that is happening, because it's not a positive one for a lot of people, because you are seeing that this King of Swords is really, you know, your enemy. So be aware of who this person is. And love is going to play a vital role. New love is coming in. Whatsoever energies that you need to work out with the King of Cups and the King of Swords, because the King of Swords shows up twice. You're walking away from that situation, but the King of Swords shows up twice. So there is a message for a lot of people out there. Be aware of who are the Aquarians, the Gemini, and the Libra, because they're coming ends, you're walking away from it, and they're going to become, so it's like an enemy and somebody who is really working against you. The next message that you have is that a new door is opening for you. So this is good. This is a wonderful openings. Whenever the energies of openings comes up, it's always the universe is making something available for you. So in this week, I need everybody to realize that if you're looking for work, it's going to happen. If you're looking to do new business, it's going to happen. Whatever new doors that you want to open up in your life, it's going to happen. Because whenever this energy of new doors comes up and open up for you, you're going to see positive things. Things that you have been asking for coming out. And I love the energy of this new door because it is always bringing positive situation in your life and positive energies in your life. The other message I want to say to people, really, if you're looking for work, it's going to be a positive week. Whatever you're looking for, but be aware of who are these sword people in your life, because they are not vibrating on a high energy vibration. They are vibrating on a low energy vibration. Whoever these people are, it's not a positive. It's not positive. Whatever they're doing, it's not positive. So you have to be aware of people whenever they're working on such a negative energies. You have to be aware of them. Okay, as we look forward, I'm using the Ascension card deck, and this is good because I'm going to be using them often. And you have the Mahatma energies. Thus, I invoke the Mahatma energies to flow through me and surround me. This energy came up also for other zodiac. So this, you know, the universal, and that's why I use the Ascension cards, and I'm going to use them often so that everyone can know what to expect from the intergalactic and the cosmic energies, because this is a powerful energy. This energy is in the golden era of Atlantis. Many great souls place some of their energies, as well as the Christ Buddha light and that of the 12 race, into a sacred pool to create a higher frequency group consciousness. People could draw from this sacred pool to ensure themselves and their projects to go good. This golden white Mahatma energy is once more available, and you are invited to draw it through your chakra system into the earth chakra. This will raise your frequency and will help the planet, for you will leave golden white footsteps everywhere you go. Send it to others to accelerate their ascension process. So if you know someone that is against you, just call up. I invoke the Mahatma energy and to flow through that person and to surround them, and that will heal the energies of you and that person. Call upon Archangel Raguel. Whenever there is imbalance in situation and people around you, call upon Archangel Raguel. But the Mahatma energy, whenever it comes up, try and use this. Go back to this video, watch it 1,000 times, and try and use it, because it's going to help you. So again, it's supposed to be 3 times, and then you said it is so and it will be. So I now invoke the Mahatma energies to flow through us and surround us. It is so and it will be. I now invoke the Mahatma energies to flow through us, and it's going to be, it is so and it will be. I'm asking the Mahatma energies to flow through us and surround us. It is so and it will be. So this is a wonderful, it's the second time it came up, and it came up also for other zodiac signs. So obviously there's a situation that is going on. I want to say thank you for returning. Thank you for being here. Thank you for this positive feedback. Thank you for the support and everything that you have been doing. And I want to say to each and every person, please support my channel by subscribing, thumbs up, likes, and share. And I'm saying namaste until next week.